Thank you so much. Good morning, everybody. My name is Serge Eric Yakodian, and then I'm board member of AFEA, African Evaluation Association, a representative of Central Africa. Because within AFEA, we have five main representations from North Africa, East Africa, Southern Africa, West Africa, and Central Africa. This is a new organization of AFEA from 2012. And also, I used to work as an independent consultant because I'm an agro-economist. I'm also a specialist of rural development, an M&E development officer. So I used to work in several countries in emergency and post-conflict environment like DRC in Congo, like in Madagascar, like in Chad, like in Ivory Coast, like in Congo Brazzaville. I used to also to chair some meeting about research and development. To make a brief, so maybe we can just present ourselves, maybe 1 minute. I don't know how many times you offer for the presentation, just the name and the, or, and the organization, or?
Yeah, you have a couple of.
I will share with you a case study from DRC about village mapping as a tool for progress assessment and development interventions. It's important to note that today, most of post-conflict and most of countries are facing a lot of conflict around the world. There's a need to frame some new tool, not new in terms of content, but new in terms of for the form to use it, to map what is the situation, reflect on the situation we face, and also reflect on how we're going to solve it. Then the village mapping can be used as a baseline, and then according to where you apply the village mapping, you can decide to frame your indicator. But for this case of DRC in the Maniema provinces, it was we used village mapping basically as a qualitative analysis, but we stop ourselves just at the frame of the mission. As a short background, as you know, DRC are facing several times some conflicts and then some destabilization within its political, economic, and social life. And from 1998 to 2004, there were this civil war in DRC, adding to the passover of the Marechal Mobutu in DRC. And then the war left the consequence that people were displaced. Some went to surrounding country. The internal displaced person on DRC managed by UN revealed some indicator about the situation. As you know, the eastern part of the DRC is one of the most affected part of the countries. You can easily see that on the map. The large majority of people who were displaced were from Lubero, Rutshuru, and Masisi, with a huge number of people. But our case study was done in Maniema provinces, basically at Kasongo and Kabambare, where about 37,000 and 65,000 of people were displaced. And then from 2004, there was new government actions with the support of international organizations to see how to give incentive to people to come back to their respective communities. And that's why PACDEF program from CARE International, from CARE in Netherlands, managed by CARE International and DRC, were set up because they were there for educate. Then there were set up the new programs to bring make a cooperation between civil society and the local government. It was a project for 3 years. But the program faced some difficulty because in regard to the aim, it was to facilitate equitable access to basic services, like providing seed and some kit or some room for livestock recovery. Also provide some access to people from drinking water, because during the war, during the civil conflict, everything was destroyed. Even the pump of water was destroyed, the road, everything was destroyed. And then they used a partnership approach as program strategy and capacity building restarting building capacity of people, staff, and also capacity of local government. After the 3 years of program, CARE is still facing some gap how to implement the project because the baseline was not concrete. Then they decided to use village mapping to map the situation and look for the progress. Simply, the approach was done in 3 steps using a mixed method. So, with the triangulation of techniques, tool, actor, and source. And then the first step was the progress assessment, during which data are collected from the 27 villages concerned by the project. But for the assessment, we limit ourselves on 3 villages because it was a capacity building mission to help the project staff and the Spanish civil society on how to use village mapping in order to achieve their objectives. So during this phase, progress was mapped using by collecting data from all Okay, I'm sorry because she said I'm speaking too loud, so maybe I can reduce the volume. You know, I'm
For us, for the others.
Exactly. So then I can do it easily because I was scared about the micro, you know, as a development worker, I don't like to stick or want to do my mission by sitting on the chair if you like we're in the classroom, no. And then to come back to our presentation, I was saying that this step was the most important step within the mission to map the progress by collecting data. And the data was resumed in the form of graph, table, to make sure that we didn't forget anything from all sides we recovered. The second step was the development process, where information was validated within the communities itself, and then we come up with agreement about the basic of the moment. So everything was framed within documents which call a village development plans with a strategy of operational frames. The last step is to frame the development intervention. What are the main projects, the priority for the moment, and the future intervention on which the project could act on, or the government could act on, or each donor or foreign organization could have a look, maybe to see where they can act. It's very important that because when we come up with the development process, community, by using their local knowledge with many tools like historical profile, we give the opportunity to them to have a look on what happened before the war, how to think and reflect on the situation by identifying the responsibility for each member of the community and take a lead to change the thing and avoid that for the future such as situation could be happening anymore. So maybe during the question phase, we can come back to the little the detail about how it was done. The first step was this training of trainer of staff member with the civil partner civil society organization. So in total, 27 participants attended the training in Kasongo office of CARE, during which they came across with an educational tool and they received a base learning experience. And then, after the training of trainer phase, there were a launch of the process. First, with a test in one village called Marungu, where all the 27 participants were involved with the supervision of the consultant on how to use the tool. And then, one of the most important things was the village map, the village card, where community themselves map where this action was done by CARE, or where is the resources, or are the resources needed to construct a school, because they have a good skill to build the mock brick. But the process was done using a simulation within a professional group of men, women, and youth, using the mixed groups to make sure that commitment have been shared, because there are some activities, some projects within the community, like a social house for meeting, which is shared by all members of the communities. The planning session was used to come up with the agreement on the decision. And as a participatory process, accommodation and food was provided by the community. So all the participants stayed within the village for 5 days, eating with the community, drinking with them, and then it gives more incentive to them to feel like, okay, that this is not a top-down approach. It's a bottom-up approach that they feel like, okay, they're a member of the activities. And at the end of the intervention, there was establishment of a local development committee, maybe by the end, by the means of election of or nomination, to monitor and evaluate all activities designed within the village development plans. And then their capacity also was as a support. The other step was report on progress. So I decided to come to put a report on progress at the end just because it linked with future intervention. So it was not that CAIRC used to support rural self-promotion by giving seed to farmers, are also giving some kit of goat or some of sheep to restart their life. There were participatory government. The participatory government was promoted, but not only was covered because there were this insecurity remaining. And then I can remember that during my time spent in BRC in Maniema, some village was still fighting, and then some was killed. Sometimes it was not easy to go to the field. There were involvement of village people in resource management and community decision making. Like, you know, during the war, some people lost their arm or they lost their feet, and some have some mental disability. But the project succeeded to bring them, give them more courage to say, okay, life is not finished, you still alive, so you have some more hope to continue living. The peace. Full resolution and prevention of conflict was really promoted, but mostly with a neighboring village, because the disability started sometime with conflict between village, and then moving to maybe to the district and from the district to the region. Finally, the beneficiaries received support to claim their right. They were assisted in claiming their right, and they were aware about their responsibility. As was mentioned before, regarding the management of their respective community. Summarily, future intervention was framed basically for the basic need, and there was a need to they agree on construct and equip a primary school of Mutang, and then with a sanitary, and then there was basically to rebuild some of drinking water. Like the photo we see. The sort of drinking water, because you know the environment was surrounded by very nice water source. We didn't need a lot of investment to have the drinking water source. You can see that they agree that the amount of money to spend for each source is only $1,500. The need of a processing unit for maize and rice, because in the past DRC didn't import rice, they didn't import maize. Then they are producing very nice quality of rice. And then during our stay in the village, by Friday, we were eating the rice produced by farmers. And then, but they lack how some technology to transform, even to grow the product after the war. There was a need to encourage women by promoting income-generating activities, like teaching them how to, in French we say couture, I don't know if it's in English, like teach them how to rebuild the dress, how to produce like a vegetable together in groups and have access to market. And there was a need to rehabilitate some rural feeder road. Like for 5 kilometers, you can see here, this road was made by hand using some traditional tool, and then it took a lot of times. And there was a need to continue supporting agriculture to the farmer by providing the agriculture implements and vaccine against livestock epidemics. Locally, some farmers were using some wheat to trade their livestock instead of maybe because they lack money to buy improved vaccine from Rwanda, basically from Rwanda, because Rwanda at that time was wasting. And then to end with the lesson, we can note that village mapping is a reference document basically for post-conflict environment, because they give you this actual, this normal situation, as I mentioned before, it could be used for baseline, and you can decide how to use your baseline, you can decide to come from the baseline make your indicator. And then by being involved within the community, beneficiary feeling has honor of intervention. So, and then the action is really appropriate. I can remember before leaving the community for the 2 months we spent over there, they still construct the mud brick for the primary school. And then the participatory method is a force for conflict resolution and peace establishment, where there is no usual common dialogue. Like I was mentioning before, some village was fighting because they never sit together and discuss. And the end, village information center, like local communication, local community radio, providing information by, in local languages, like Kichwali, is a key tool to boosting people's confidence. Like, before moving from one village to another, the next village were already aware that we are coming, or we are doing this thing, or they are informed that this village is improving better. So, and then they feel like, hey guys, let's wake up and change, look and take the lead on our activities. So at the end, we make some recommendation that there's a need to continue supporting local development committee by basically by building up their capacity. There's a need to synthesize and implement priority need, the micro projects per village, to give more incentive to communities. And on the long run, the operational and strategic plan within the village development plan could serve as a framework to design a new project and new programs, because all everybody can get access to the document. You just go there, go to the office of the local authority, ask the document, say, oh, this is very the real situation of the Omanima provinces. You can add on. And then they will need to encourage the duplication of this tool on most other post-conflict environment. We have to thank the local community of Bahamaza because they were very, very friendly. And if you need more formal information, you can send an email or you can contact Kennedy. Thank you so much. And I'm sure we have some questions.